Tremendous crowd reaction to Mike, but then he electrifies the crowd. He ripped the towel over his head and threw it on the canvas in front of Clifford Etienne in a sort of intimidating sort of manner. I'll tell you one thing, folks. There's no place I'd rather be than right here right now with this one. Because no matter what happens with Mike Tyson involved, it is exciting. This crowd is absolutely electricity. Clifford Etienne decked out in his red trunks. There it is, the good shot of the Maori tattoo. Evidently, Mike saw a story on the Warriors of New Zealand. And that's what he modeled that tattoo from. And he says it's going to cover the whole side of his face one of these days. Probably not such a good idea to get a tattoo like that 10 days before a fight. It created pandemonium, as you well know. As you take a look at the tail of the tape, it'll tell you a couple of things. Mike Tyson is 3 inches shorter. He's 3 pounds heavier. He's 4 years older than Clifford Etienne. And he has a 2.5-inch shorter reach. He's coming off that loss last June to Lennox Lewis. You take a look at the rules, the 10-point must scoring system. There is a standing 8 count. There is a 3-knockdown rule. And a fighter can be saved by the bell in the last round only. Only the referee can stop a fight. These are the local rules of boxing here in the state of Tennessee. And by the way, just in case the heads come together or anything of that nature, accidental headbutt, a little bit different than the unified rules. The fight must start the 4th round before it becomes official. So here we go. Here's Jimmy Lennon Jr.
Ladies and gentlemen, a very good evening to you and welcome to the Pyramid here in Memphis, Tennessee for our big night of action and our featured bout of the evening. And it's all brought to you by Gary Shaw Productions, Prize Fight Promotions, and Fight Night, Inc. in association with Grand Casino Tunica. This bout coming away is sanctioned by the Tennessee Boxing Commission, the director, Tommy Patrick, our physicians at ringside, Dr. Mike Miller and Dr. Jerry Floyd. Timekeeper at the bell is Doug Atkin, keeping count of the knockdowns, Stephen McAdoo. Introducing to you our three judges scoring this bout from ringside, from Chattanooga, Tennessee, Richard Barth. From Biloxi, Mississippi, Fred Steinwinder III, and from Franklin, Tennessee, Ken Whitehead. Our third man to the ring, the referee in charge of this bout, from Pittsboro, North Carolina, Bill Clancy. All right, fans, here we go with our main event of the evening. 10 rounds of boxing at a heavyweight special attraction. And now, ladies and gentlemen in attendance and boxing fans joining us around the world, it's the time you've all been waiting for. Live from Memphis, it is showtime. Introducing to you first on my left, he is fighting out of the blue corner, wearing red trunks and joining us from Baton Rouge, Louisiana. He weighed in at 222.75 pounds with a record of 24 wins, 1 loss, and 1 draw. He has 17 wins coming by way of knockout. He is ranked number 7 in the world by the IBF, number 3 by the WBO. Tonight, he makes a charge toward a heavyweight world title challenge. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the Black Rhino, introducing Clifford Etienne. And his opponent across the ring on my right, fighting out of the red corner, really needing no introduction the world over, entering the ring wearing his traditional black trunks and hailing from Catskill, New York. His weight, 225 and three-quarter pounds. His fearsome record includes 49 wins, 4 losses, 2 no contests, with 43 big wins coming by way of knockout. Having already established himself in the record books as boxing's youngest heavyweight champion, tonight he renews his quest to dominate the division. Introducing the number 4 ranked heavyweight contender, here is the former undisputed heavyweight champion of the world. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the one and only Iron Mike Tyson. Once again, a referee in charge, Bill Clancy, now to give instructions. 10 rounds of action scheduled.
Bring it in here, Mike. All right, Mike and Cliff, we're scheduled for 10 rounds. I know we went through the instructions in the dressing room. You must obey my commands at all times. Give me a good, clean fight. Protect yourself. Mike, you're a little high right here. Freddie's a little high. If it rides up, okay? We'll watch it. Cliff, you're okay. Give me a good, clean fight, gentlemen. Obey my commands. Any questions, Mike? Any questions, Cliff? Touch them up, gentlemen. God bless. Good luck.
All right, we're set to go. There's no heavyweight championship at stake, but there is heavyweight championship electricity in this crowd, my friends. We're at the Pyramid in Memphis, Tennessee. There's Mike Tyson. There are the tattoos. I'm Bob Sheridan. Glad that you can be with us around the world, and I just hope that you feel the excitement for the start of this fight that we feel right here in Memphis. There he is, Clifford Etienne. He's a guy who's very aggressive, and we'll see how aggressive he's going to be with Mike Tyson in the early going. If all predictions are true, it should be fast and furious in the early going. Here we go. Etienne right across the ring. Neither guy has thrown a punch yet. Etienne reaches out with the left hand. Mike on top of him. Bangs him with the left hook right away. Etienne bends over, then hangs on and walks him back and falls towards Mike Tyson. And time is called. Now, Bill Clancy, the referee, will talk to Etienne about making it sloppy. They want to keep it clean. And he dusts the gloves off of Mike Tyson as well. Etienne wants to be assured he established with Mike Tyson that he's not afraid of him. Mike showing nice head movement and rolling a little bit. He bangs Mike inside with the right hand. Wow, the right hand is Etienne. Etienne tries to catch him. Tyson ties him up now. Etienne hanging on. And the referee, Bill Clancy, able to separate the two. Good instructions given by the ref in the early going. Mike gets him with the right hand, and Etienne is down. He was really nailed with a punch right hand. It's up to 5 and 6. He's not going to make it. It's 7, 8, 9, and 10. He knocks him out in the first round with a punch right hand. Man, before the seats get hot in the Pyramid, a crunching right hand to the side of the jaw of Clifford Etienne, and it's all over. Mike Tyson, in dramatic fashion, knocks out Clifford Etienne in the early seconds of the first round. It came in a bolt out of the blue at 49 seconds of the first round. How about that? Wow. Well, you can say what you want, but he's the best first-round fighter maybe in the history of the heavyweight division. Mike Tyson. The million-dollar punch on the jaw taken by Etienne. A crushing right-hand shot. And it's been that sort of night here at the Pyramid with first and second-round knockouts, and this one's no exception. We really expected Etienne to give him some problems early, but it didn't work that way because Mike caught him with a flush right hand. And for all the talk about the lack of preparation, the 5 good weeks that this man had were enough to handle Clifford Etienne at 49 seconds of the first round as it came and nailed him right high on the cheek. On the left side of the cheek of Clifford Etienne, and it's all she wrote as he was counted out. Tyson knocks him out at 49 seconds of the first round. And in all honesty, that's exactly the kind of performance that Tyson needed. Let's get it from Jimmy Lennon.
And 49 seconds in round number 1. A referee in charge, Bill Clancy, reaches the count of 10. He's the winner by way of knockout, Iron Mike Tyson.
Boy, how about that? Mike Tyson, before the seats got warm, just nailed him with the right hand. Now, Jim Gray is right in there with him. We're going to pick this interview up. As soon as Jim has Mike. There's Jim there as you see him, and he'll grab Mike as soon as.
That's how we get right.
You got to tell him more about this match.
Buddy McGurk.
Thank you, buddy.
Love you, man. God bless you, man. Yeah, Mike.
Come a long way.
I'm trying, sir.
You're still doing it. Still
since I'm 14.
Mike,
you,
Clifford Etienne pulled you aside, Mike. And he said something to you in your ear that nobody could hear. What exactly was it that he said?
To be honest, he said you need to stop bullshitting and be serious. You're not serious. That's why you out here playing around. He said the truth.
And he is right, isn't he?
Yeah, he is. I'm just happy to be back in Memphis and give a decent show. And I'm glad brother Clifford gave me a fight. And people don't understand the business when you show your love and respect. When you fight one another, because that's how we elevate our lifestyle. We take care of our fighters, our family. So we can't say, hey, I'm scared to fight anybody. And closely, we're both Muslim, we're brothers. We owe each other to fight each other, to elevate our life.
Mike, were you really sick this week? What was the problem?
I broke my back.
What do you mean by that? You
broke my back is broken.
What, a vertebrae or what portion?
Spinal.
You did that in sparring?
No, I did it... probably a motorcycle accident. The doctor discovered I was doing my sit-ups 2,500 a day with my 20-pound weight, and one day I couldn't move anymore. And I asked the doctor, what's wrong? And he said, believe it or not, it's wearing your back is broken slightly.
So are you in pain right now? Did you take some type of injection? How did you make it to this fight?
I can't take an injection. You know you're going to test me. But all praise be to Allah. I don't know. I don't even know. I'm just happy that I'm fighting and I punch him well and accurate, that my trainer, Freddie Roach, Robert Lewis, oh, God, I'm sorry, Tyrone Boone.
Were
Boom.
You ready for this fight, Mike? I mean, your trainer advised you 4 days, Freddie, before the fight, not to fight. Were you ready?
No, but I'm obligated, and I got to be a man and fight. I canceled too many fights in my career, and I wasn't afraid. I didn't want anybody to think I was afraid, and he needed the money. I'm always in need of money, and I'm glad the both of us did. I have so much respect for him as a man. You know, he's a good man. I respect him, and he's a friend of mine. And I realize when Sugar Ray Robinson and Henry Armstrong fought, and that was Robinson's hero, Henry Armstrong went up to him and said, if you're my friend and you care and remind me, you would fight me. You know I need money. And that's how it is with fighters. Fighters, you understand that. Don't say you don't want to fight. And when a man says he doesn't want to fight you, that's disrespecting you because he knows you need you to make a living.
And you both needed each other in this instance, Mike. Let's take a look, if we can, here at this fight. Tell us exactly what happened as the slip at the beginning, and then you two embraced and went down.
Boom. I'm a little rusty. I'm missing. I'm not moving my head. He hit me with, a slight left hook of my eye.
Is that what caused the cut, Mike? Is that what caused the cut above your eye?
I believe so. The left hook, he hit me, yes.
Oh, he did hit you?
Yes, he did.
Let's take a look now at the slip once again, and then we'll take a look at the knockout. Here it is.
I'm setting him up. I'm looking at it. I think this winner we're pushing, though.
That was when he was hurt.
I pulled him down. He didn't push me. I pulled him down.
But he was hurt from that first punch. Now we go here.
But I know he was pushing me, so I...
Tell us about the right here.
Down.
Okay, and here's the knockout,
I'm trying
the right.
To keep my hands up. I'm moving. I'm trying to get to the side and look for the opening. And I see it.
And here it is.
Boom. Straight. Boom. Just like the one Freddie Roach was working
now
right
now. You've hit a lot of people, Mike, and I know it may be a little quick to estimate this. Have you hit anybody harder than that?
Well, I don't know because I didn't feel a punch, so I have to go around and ask everybody I hit how did that punch feel.
Well, you know because you delivered it.
I'm just glad he didn't hurt his leg. But I was just very happy with the sharp punch, an accurate punch, and praise be to Allah, no one gotten hurt.
Mike, we have a couple of other things before we talk about Lennox Lewis, but the country's interested in the tattoo. Why the tattoo, and why so close to the fight?
I'm just, that's just me, who I am. I don't care about no tattoo and fight. People fight, and that just happens. We do this. I don't know about no warrior and all that stuff. This is just what I do. I fight for a living. I'm in a hurt business, and no one should care if I get hurt, if I die in the ring, because this is what we do. It's what we do.
That's just people fighting out in the stands. They didn't get enough of you, I guess, but let's keep you here, Mike. Lennox Lewis will be next. It'll be in June. What do you think will be different this time?
Well, I'll be more confident this time. And to be honest, I don't believe I'm ready to fight him at this moment. I'm not going to lie to myself. I'm not going to lie to the public. I need more fights, and I'm not interested in getting beat up again.
So what will you do in between now and then to get ready if you're not interested in getting beaten up again so it doesn't end the same way?
I'll leave here and go right to the gym in a week later, continue my exercise, and just continue to go training. And hopefully, you know, it's all praise be to God. I don't know. I don't even know if I want to fight no more. If I have to fight Lennox Lewis, my next fight, there's no way I have to continue fighting.
You don't know if you want to fight Lewis, or you don't know if you want to fight after that?
Well, I don't know. I don't want to fight Lewis right this moment. But if I'm capable to get two or three more fights, probably two, I'll fight him right away. My only problem with Lewis, you must understand, if I've never been absent for 5 years, Holyfield, all these guys that beat me, they would never have a career. It was all in God's plan to take care of them. Allah loved them. He put his, Holyfield may say, Jesus, they love them. They put their arm around them, put them in their bosom, and they elevate their lives. But eventually, I'll continue to, training and bring my life together. I just want to get my shit together. I'm so messed up, man. I just need to get my life together, brother.
All right, Mike, we thank you for your time and congratulations on the fight.
Thank you, too, sir.
All right, back here live. A couple of important things to point out is that at the end, on the way out, accidentally hit a woman in the head as he went out. It was just an accident as he was coming down here, as you'll see. And it was just as he was coming out, and then the people thought that he did something on purpose, and the lady starts yelling back at him, and of course he feels terrible that happened. He said, "Nah, I didn't do it on purpose," and that's what that whole hullabaloo was all about. The important thing is Mike says he has a broken back. He was cut up on the right eyebrow, which you have to question how his eyes would hold up if he got another battle with Lennox Lewis. He said he doesn't want to fight Lennox Lewis. He said something about he might retire, and he said he's totally messed up. So with all that said, we don't know any more about Mike Tyson post-interview than we knew beforehand, but he thought I made it pretty clear when he said that he doesn't want to fight Lennox Lewis next and that he does want to go back into the gym next week and get going. Well, we want to thank all the boys from Painaway, Johnny Carroll and Russell Tates, and all the lads that helped us out get ready for this fight. The boys from Brenner's Weichel, Steve Brenner and John Bayrudy, and from the Showtime Network, Mike Teodoro, we appreciate all your help in getting ready for the fight. Our transmission has been provided by the Casey Company and Barbara Sipes. Our ringside security, Pancho Lamon. Our stage manager has been Melinda Laval. Helping me with stats, as usual, Jody Heaps. Our producer has been Jason Bidell. Our director, Frank Belmont. And for our executive producer, who is also Frank Belmont, and an entire production staff here at Belmonte Productions, I'm the Colonel, Bob Sheridan, saying good night, everybody. So long from Memphis, Tennessee.